I would like to pick up exactly where the last video ended. When air temperature drops or is dropping, and it reaches the dew point temperature, remember there are two different temperatures going on here. Air temperature is what you sense in the air. If I say it's 65 degrees, you know what that means. If I say it's 95 degrees, you know what that means. Dew point temperature has to do with the water that's in the atmosphere. When air temperature drops and it reaches the dew point temperature, at that point, the air is saturated and the relative humidity is 100%. Remember, those three things always go together. Relative humidity 100%, air being saturated, dew point temperature and air temperature being the same number. There is no way this can be anything else. Those three things always go together. So there is no vegetarian option on this menu, okay? If the dew point temperature is above 32 degrees and the air is saturated, the relative humidity is 100%, air temperature, dew point temperature, same number, condensation will occur, which of course is the water going from a gas to a liquid. And if the dew point temperature is 32 degrees or lower, sublimation, also known as deposition, will occur. Let's take a look back at this graph, this 24-hour graph that goes from midnight to midnight. Notice that when air temperature is going up, relative humidity is going down, and when air temperature is going down, relative humidity is going up. These two things have an inverse relationship to each other. There, I just highlighted relative humidity with the purple and air temperature with the kind of lime green. So you can see that these things are inverse. And again, I want to point this out to you. If the dew point temperature is over there on the left-hand side represented by the blue line and it's 55 degrees, and the air temperature is on the right-hand side represented by the red line and it's 75 degrees, if the air temperature begins to drop, so it's 75, then 70, then 65, then 60, at that point, air temperature and dew point temperature are the same number. And now that air temperature and dew point temperature are the same number, we can also say the air is saturated, the relative humidity is 100%, and something is going to happen. We're going to begin to go through those some things. Condensation happens when water goes from a gas or a vapor, remember these are synonymous terms, to a liquid. There are multiple forms of condensation. Let's start with this one. Why is water forming on the outside of these glasses? Take a look at the one on the left where you can obviously see there's water on the outside of the glass, and the one on the right where you can see the water dripping down the glass. Why is that happening? Well, let's look at the one on the right. That has a soda in it, and the soda has ice in it, as you can probably tell. So what has happened? Tell me this, did this happen? Did the soda magically, mystically, through osmosis, go through the glass molecules and then form on the outside of the glass, losing all of its color, losing all of the sugar, losing all of the flavoring, and then just become pure water? Is that what happened? We know that's not what happened. What's going on is dew. Dew is condensation onto the surface of an object that has dropped below the dew point temperature. There's actually quite a lot to unpack with that definition. The object is below the dew point temperature. In other words, it's condensation onto the surface of a thing, an object. And that object is below the dew point temperature of the air. The object then cools the air that's in contact with it. And remember, air takes on the characteristics of whatever it's over. So if the air is in contact with something hot, it gets hot. But if the air is in contact with something cold, it gets cold. And remember, as air temperature goes down, relative humidity goes up. There you go. As air temperature drops, relative humidity rises. This is rule number two. Back to these glasses. Why is water forming on the outside of the glasses? Well, again, let's look at the right-hand side. I think you could see the dew a little better on the left-hand side, but let's look at the right-hand side. We know that the soda is in there and there's ice with the soda. And what has happened is That cold liquid on the inside of the glass has cooled the temperature of the glass down. Then the air that's touching the glass, and I literally mean like only 1 inch of air that's touching the glass, that air also has cooled down. If you take your hands and you cup them so they both make like the letter C, your right hand, your left hand, and then if you had a glass of soda in between them and your hands are about a foot away on either side and you slowly bring your hands towards the glass, I'm doing it right now. What you would see happening would be this, or what you would feel happening would be once you got about an inch away from the glass, you would actually, with your hands, feel the coolness. You're not touching the glass, so you must be feeling the coolness of the air that has been chilled by being in contact with that cold glass, and that is exactly what you are feeling. So the cold glass has cooled down the air that's in contact, and as air temperature goes down, relative humidity goes up. Now, I went out to my car this morning at 6 o'clock, and there was dew on the car. Why was there dew on the car? I didn't fill my car up with ice and soda, so why was there dew on the car? But if you go out to your car at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, there's not going to be any dew on it. What is the difference between these things? Well, obviously, in the morning, the temperature is lower, and in the afternoon, the temperature is higher. But in addition to that, metal especially is a good conductor of heat, which means it absorbs the heat energy very easily, but it loses it quickly. This is why if you park your car out in the sun on a day when it's 85 degrees, and you leave it in the sun for 2 or 3 hours, and you come back, the air temperature might be 85 degrees, but if you touch the top of your car that's been sitting in the sun, it is at 85. It's much hotter than 85 degrees. It's because that metal is excellent at absorbing that shortwave radiation. The problem is it doesn't store it. And so what happens at night when the sun goes down is that metal loses all of this energy that's not being replaced because there's no shortwave radiation coming in. So the temperature of the metal and the glass, for that matter, the windshield, drops down very rapidly. If it's a calm night, the air that's in contact also drops down because the air takes on the characteristics of what it's touching. And the result of that is that if you drop the temperature down enough, the air temperature hits the dew point temperature, just like the line that I showed you, the red line going down. And once the air temperature and the dew point temperature are the same number, the relative humidity is 100%, the air is saturated. And something has to happen. In this case, dew comes out. The water squeezes out of the atmosphere onto the surface of that thing, being my car. The manner in which dew forms will act in a way as the basis for the other forms of condensation and sublimation deposition that we will talk about.